Wadzi, Tammy, Mavis, Mom, Stanley, Dad, Simba, the youngest brother. I want to welcome you to this sad gathering. Friends, colleagues, all of us who are here today, we came with one sad reason. And it is unique, significant, nothing like this, which somehow unites us all. Thank you for coming today. My name is Milan Popovic. I'm one of the pastors of this church here. And I knew the family, and I knew Shingi as well. We came here for this time just to remember and to reflect short period of time. Shingi was with us here. And during the next 60 minutes or so, we will see some pictures, we will hear some words, we will even sing a song. But I want us all to keep in mind, why did we come here? And that is to remember Shingi, to support the family, to try to comfort them. Maybe Stanley, Simba, Wadzi, Tammy, your pain is our pain. And your tears are our tears. Allow me just to share a few technical details with you as we start the program. You have probably already noticed that restrooms are on my right-hand side, on your left, just across the lawn. I also want to invite you that after the program, there will be some refreshments, and we want to ask you, please plan to stay to spend some more time with family afterwards as well. I also want to invite you to and to remind you to, in case you have not potentially switched off your mobile phone, please do it so now, or put it in silence mode or flight mode as well. That would be much appreciated. At the very start, we will hear one hymn, and the title of that hymn is Because He Lives. It is a well-known Christian hymn. I would like to invite Helena and other singers to join me here at the front, and you can find the words in the program as well. And if you find it that you'd like to join, feel free to join us as well. When we hear the sound of music, I would also like to invite you just to stand up, and we will join our voices. As the singers are preparing, I also want to share with you something which I already just mentioned. These kind of things and events unite us all, regardless where we're from, regardless on our faith, belief, values. We have the same destiny in that context. And in that spirit, I want to talk to you and to family. Thank you.
We invite you to stand and sing with us this hope that we have in our God, Jesus Christ. He lives.
Thank you.
Standing, I would like to ask you for two items. First one is a personal reflection, a reflection of what life actually is, a moment of silence following after that. And in that moment of silence, as we call it, minute of silence, we want to pay respect to Shingi. And after that, shortly, you will hear my words of prayer. I will pray loudly. So let us do that. Thank you. Lord Jesus, we gather here today with saddened hearts, with many questions raised, and yet little answers. Lord, we gather here today to remember Shingai, or Shingi as we know him. He went too early, Lord. And family, friends, all of us here today are with hearts full of sorrow, full of tears, grasping for answers, Lord. And as we commence this service, memorial service, Lord, today, we ask you for your presence. We ask you that this hope about your live, your life, we ask that that hope fills the hope and the hearts of all of us, Lord, because you live, we can live, and Shingi will live when time comes. Lord, we ask you that your presence be with the family, with mom and dad and brother in Africa. Be with Tammy Wadzi, her family here, dear Lord. Be with all of us, please. Because there is hope, and Shingi believed in that hope. We ask you this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you. I'd like to invite Valentin now to share with us words of eulogy. Thank you, Valentin.
We are all gathered here, not only in our desire to pay our last respect, but also in our need to do so. Today we say goodbye to a brother, a partner, a friend, a son, and a colleague. Shingai Takuzwa Parerewa. Born on the 3rd of February 1990 in the capital city of Zimbabwe, Harare, to Mr. Stanley and Mrs. Mavis Parerewa. He was a middle child in a family of three, older brother to Simbarashe Parerewa, and a younger brother to Wazanai Parerewa. Growing up, Shingi was good at sport, played a lot of football, scored many hat-tricks, amongst other accolades. Some refer to him as Thierry Henry. He was a boy fascinated by cars, loved to tinker around with electronics, and easily able to fix broken gadgets around the house. He was actively involved in church, and he absolutely loved a cappella music. The first time I met Shinky was in the year 2018. Wadzi didn't really give me a heads up that I was meeting him on a day. So it was a surprise. And many guys here would agree with me that meeting your partner, brother, for the first time is a big deal. He'll be sizing you up, which he did. Shinky was a person who had a passion for good food, hence his nickname, Greedy Soros. I remember a day when he made an oxtail dish for us. That is, without a doubt, the best oxtail dish that I've ever had my whole life. Even though he taught me the recipe, to this day, I haven't made anything half as good as his was. Anyone who met Shinky knows that there were always laughs to be shared. It was impossible to spend some time with him without enjoying a gut-busting laugh at some point in the conversation. Shinky was naturally a comic, and his jokes were quick-witted and hilarious. There was never really a dull moment with Shingai. Even through those times he was going through so much pain, he managed to keep his energy, his optimism, his zest for life, and he kept all the nurses laughing. Nothing shook him. He stood strong and maintained his buoyant spirits to the very end. Shinky wholeheartedly loved his family, his partner, and his friends. Shinky and I used to talk about how important our families were to us and how we should always love and cherish them. And to his friends here today, I just want you to know that he considered you his family. He was a warm-hearted person, very calm in all circumstances. Shinky knew how to deliver even a difficult message without being aggressive, without yelling, or losing his temper. Beneath that fun-loving personality, Shinky brought a lot of depth, and for men in the room, he was a confidant, a source of advice, and above all, a voice of reason. I remember the last few days of his life. He was still looking out for everybody, asking his loved ones how they were doing, watching animal documentaries for comfort, and reassuring everyone that everything will be okay. As a partner, Shinky was literally everything to Tammy. He was the reason her heart and soul smiled, laughed, and sang every single day. He was a best friend, her soulmate, her great love, her number one cheerleader, and her favorite human being on the planet. Tammy felt his kindness, selflessness, and his warmth. And every day, his presence inspired her to wake up a better person. His proudest moments were settling down with the woman he loved, securing a job with a phenomenal company, LSKD, and being able to build a new life for himself and his partner. Although Shinky was taken from us way too young, I have learned that it's never too soon or too late to tell someone how much they mean to you, and to never take a single day for granted. Shinky lived in the moment, really loved his life. I know that's what he would want us to do today, no matter how difficult it is without him. Now, as we say farewell to Shingi, we will remember him for his outgoing personality, the ability to see the best in people, and his great sense of humor, and also a genuine, caring heart. We will miss you, Shingi. Till we meet again. Thank you.
That was really moving. We'll have an opportunity now to see a portion of Shingi's life through pictures. People say that one picture speaks like 1,000 words. So let's just see together many words. Thank you.
So everyone will know.
As you can see, that Shingi was full of life, young man, 32 years of age. He loved life, he loved to laugh, and would like to invite now friends and others to join me here at the front to share some stories and their memories of Shingi. If I may have Gizzy and Zali joining me here. Thank you.
There's many things that we would want to share about Shingi, but I've got a quote that sums up the essence of who he was to everybody. There are some people who bring a light so great to the world that even after they are gone, the light remains. Shingi, your passion, your laughter and joy is what we remember and what we hold on to. You radiated joy everywhere you went and touched our hearts of everyone you met. You may be gone, but your laughter continues to echo on. I watched you in your last hours continuing to fight. You showed strength and you fought right till the end. You are a rare gem in this world, and my hope is that we can all learn and grow from what you left behind. May your positive energy, your kindness, your passion and strength be the guidance through this sadness and heartache. Shingi, we promise to love and support your Temmie as she walks this difficult path. We promise that we will be by her side and get her through to the end. May you rest now and be at peace. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Gizzy and Zali. If I could invite Tepera, Simba and Benji to join us here. Thank you.
Hi all. My name is Simba. And on behalf of Shingi's friends, I'd like to thank you all for being here. So nice to see how many people loved and cared about Shingi. I met Shingi back in 2017 when he was still studying his master's in accounting at Griffith University. We instantly became friends, and first thing I noticed about Shingi was his honesty. In fact, he was brutally honest with everyone. Shingi was one of a kind because he was brutally honest with no regard for anyone's feelings, but he still managed to maintain great relationships with everyone around him. I would spend the whole day talking about all the things he did as a great friend, but I'll digress and let you guys know about his passion and what we learned from him. Shingi spent most of his time in Australia furthering his career as an accountant, which was a field he was really passionate about. He faced so many obstacles ever since he landed in Australia, but the way he confronted his problems without giving up was inspiring and was also ensuring to us as his friends that he will come out on top in any situation. Shingi also spent most of his time maintaining the image of a modern gentleman. That is, he would collect expensive colognes that we used to steal. He would buy expensive watches. And for those that know him, He was always practicing his firm handshake as if he had an interview the next day. He had a great admiration for his sister Wazanai, as she provided guidance, and he would always talk about her career accomplishments. He was forever thankful for his loving fiancée, Temwa, for all the good times and for her support as he battled with leukemia. I relocated to Melbourne around the same time Shingi was admitted into the hospital. And unfortunately, our conversations were limited to video calls and voice notes. If my brother was here, Shingi, to you, I would have told you that, my brother, you fought a good fight. You taught me a lot. You inspired so many. You were loved. You were dearly loved. You can never be forgotten. And I want you to rest in peace.
Thank you.
I would first like to start off by thanking each and every one of you that has come, not only today, but over the past days as we've remembered Shingi. It has truly been a beautiful thing to see the many different faces that interacted with Shingi during his time here. I know I speak for many when I say Shingi was a supportive person who wanted nothing but the best for each and every person he interacted with. I will now shortly speak on the times I would visit Shingi in hospital. From the first time I visited Shingi in hospital to the last time I visited him, Shingi never questioned why him. Instead, Shingi focused on my well-being and how the rest of our friendship group was doing. Shingi, like he had always done, continued to give me profound advice about my career and my personal life. We would talk about basketball. In fact, as I stand here and speak, I can visualize Shingi as I walked into his ward every time, lying on his bed, on his silver laptop, in his laps, his gray headphones on, and would greet me with a Shamwari, Lakers, yakato tadza kupinda ma playoffs. Shingi would always be joking with us, and then always be joking with the nurses in spite of his condition. And a constant was the love and appreciation he had for you, Temwa. He truly loved you and appreciated every single second he spent with you. He would always tell me how appreciative he was of your support whilst he was in there, and for you, for Valentine, for all his friends, for every single person that went to visit him, for those who couldn't make it, he was always very grateful. I also want to thank his workplace. Shingi was constantly talking about you and very appreciative of the support that you guys provided him with throughout this difficult time. Now on to what do I want to say to Shingi personally. I firstly met Shingi in 2017, and from that moment our friendship and brotherhood only grew. Along with some of the gentlemen I stand with here, you are my best friend, you are my brother, and I will miss our usual activities, which included being your personal barber every Saturday, messing up your beard, and then you would go at me for it for the next week and tell me next time you can do better, but you never ran away from trusting in my skill set. We'd go shopping, golf, betting $5 on our FIFA games, which you'd always win, and then I'd always find a way to win that money back later on in the day. I will miss our advice, the advice you always gave me. I will miss your smile, and I will miss the love that you had for us. The last words Shingi and I exchanged the last time I saw him 2 weeks ago in hospital was goodbye, Mfis. I did not know that would be the last time I would see him. His last message to me the day before he passed on, we were laughing about basketball, and he was laughing at the Suns that had just lost a game. I know you will always be with us, but for now, I will say, go well, my friend. Go well, my brother. We will all truly miss you.
I'm just going to start off with an encouraging verse that my mother shared with me after learning of the passing of my friend. 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13 to 18. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others who do, who have no more hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so through Jesus, God will bring him with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by a word from the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with the cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. For those who don't know me, my name is Benji Mjari, and I first met Chingy in his first few months of him being in Australia at Griffith University through a mutual friend called Maz, who is here today. From that point onwards, we started hanging out more and became close friends. I have many enjoyable stories of Chingy, but today I'll highlight who Chingy was, particularly his most memorable character traits. Chingy's most memorable character trait was that he was one easy person to talk to. It was so easy, you didn't have to think twice about sharing anything with him in fear of being judged. You could bring up anything with Chingy: relationships, future goals, workplace issues, literally anything. And he was always encouraging. He would be positive in his approach, but very real in his opinions and suggestions to go about these issues that you would share with him. He was really a unique friend who was kind, had a great sense of humor, and generous. And when I say generous, I mean generous in every sense of that word. I would like to close this short tribute by sharing what my father said to me, and I hope this encourages everyone as much as it did to me. I'm going to paraphrase it, but he said, "As painful as this untimely death is, don't be in despair, but be energized to live out Chingy's dreams and character traits, to carry his legacy on and keep his energy alive." And I also wrote a subset of those traits that I'll share with everyone today. A fighter. Chingy was always a fighter. No matter what setbacks he had, he always used to bounce back. Being positive, Chingy was always a person who looked at things from a glass half full perspective. Being generous, Chingy was always generous. And kindness in every perspective. Being kind, Chingy was a kind person. And lastly, Chingy had a great sense of humor.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Benji, Simba, and Tapera. Chingy was a beloved member of company LSKS, and I would like to give an opportunity to representatives from his collective to come forward and to share with us. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. The man you knew as Chingy, we knew by a different name. He applied for a job with us in October 2020 with his Christian name listed as Oliver on his CV. He later told us that he had not been getting any interviews using his real name, so he decided to use a name he thought prospective employers would recognise. We only discovered this some months later, and when given the choice, he decided to continue using Oliver as his work persona. So you'll forgive me if I continue to refer to him as Oliver or Ollie. It is how we remember him at LSKD, and I don't think he'd mind a bit. I speak today not only on my own behalf, but also on the behalf of all Ollie's teammates at LSKD. When we interviewed Ollie, we liked him immediately, enough even to offer him the job that same day. He presented himself to us dressed immaculately with a very expensive watch, a man looking for his big opportunity. I remember thinking to myself that he possessed all the qualities we look for in our staff. He was humble, respectful, polite, and intelligent with a fire in his eyes. He was ready to make his mark. At this point, we were not aware of the sacrifices he had made to get to this point in his career. His master's in accounting qualification had been earned through sheer persistence and graft. He was working multiple jobs and regularly doing night shifts, stacking shelves to fund his studies. At LSKD, he had found his big opportunity and he got stuck in, excelling at the role and becoming a much loved and respected teammate. I would always notice how so many members of the team had very quickly developed a warm friendship with him. He was the ideal team player. Humble, conscientious, dedicated, professional, and exuding warmth and humanity. He also did not mind the occasional joke at his expense. He loved to laugh at himself. We were very lucky to get the opportunity to work with Ollie and get to know him as a colleague and as a friend. In August last year, we worked together on his professional and personal goals. He wanted to get qualified as a chartered accountant, learn the job, rise through the ranks, earn some more money, get fit, get married, and have a family. He was excited about his future at LSKD, and indeed his future looked bright. It is this that makes the cruelty of his illness so hard to accept. It robbed Ollie of a life not even barely begun, and it has robbed all of us of one of life's good guys. It took from us a colleague, a friend, a son, a brother, a partner. But the lessons we can learn from Ollie in life are the same as were present in his fight against illness and in his death. Persistence, fight, grace, and humility in adversity. Ollie displayed all these qualities in spades, in good times and bad. When I reflect on our mate Ollie, our teammate at LSKD, I think how much he was one of us. A true believer, he would have carved out a long and successful career working at LSKD and gone on to achieve anything he set his mind to. He even wore our brand in hospital all the way to the end, even getting a discount code for the nurses to use who were fascinated by his attachment to this brand. His death at such a young age reminds us of the preciousness and delicacy of life, that we must make every opportunity and moment count. It is a gift for all of us he has left behind that we are alive and healthy, and we must make the most of it in Ollie's memory. We as a business will make sure to honour his memory at every opportunity we can. Ollie, I miss you, mate. I'll never forget you and the lessons you've provided me in life and in death. May you forever rest in peace.
Thank you. Isn't this amazing to learn some new stuff about Ollie? What a great man. What a great man. I would like to invite Elvis to join me here as well and to share his memories before I share a few words. Take your time, Elvis, and
thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone, for coming here today to celebrate Shinki's life. I've known Shinki ever since he was a young boy, primary school, before he was a teenager from Zimbabwe. Back then, he was just another youngster. And I viewed Shinki as a little brother. I remember before I came to Australia, I hung around with him in Zimbabwe, and I told him that I'm going to Australia, and by then he had graduated from university in South Africa. He was working as an accountant, which was something that I was proud of him. When I came to Australia, once he told us that he was going to get Shinki to come to Australia, and I was so excited for Shinki, because I knew the type of a person that he was, the type of lifestyle that he wanted to lead. And for most of you, you can confirm that Shinki loved his good food, he loved his music, he loved dressing well. And when he came to Australia, I could see each and every step he took to try and own his destiny. He worked very hard. He fell in love with Temwa. He made Wadzi proud. He managed to graduate when we were in Zimbabwe, he was not really my friend because he was much younger than me. But the moment he came to Australia, we developed a friendship. After graduating, he decided to make me his mentor because I'm... And through that process, he always kept me informed when he was applying for roles. Even when he applied for the role at LSKD, all the things that were in the pipeline, he started off as an assistant accountant. He was now an accountant, and there were so many things in the background. He had started doing his chartered accountancy. I remember visiting Shingi in the hospital, and Shingi was a positive person. He brought joy and laughter wherever he went. He always managed to make everyone smile. He was never afraid for a challenge. He was always eager to learn more and explore more things in life. One thing that I admire about Shingi, it was his strength and the courage he showed me when he was in hospital. I remember visiting him. He always told me that he is going to be positive. He remained positive up until the end. His full name, it's Shingi Rai. It's a Shona name that means endurance or perseverance. And I know up until the end, Shingi endured and was perseverant to try and beat this disease. I salute you, Shingi, for the joy you brought in our lives, for the memories you've left with us, for the patience, for the positive energy, for your hard work, for your generosity, for your devotion to family, for your unconditional love, and for not giving up. As Shingi's mentor in his career, he was supposed to learn from me. But I remember when he was discharged from the hospital, we had a conversation. Instead of me being his mentor, he was my mentor. And I will always remember that conversation. It made me a better person, and it will make me a better person forever. Because Shingi was such a positive energy, no matter how difficult this is for us, I know one thing that he would want is for us to remain positive. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing those amazing words and helping us to know Shingi Oli better, more. It is interesting to notice that we'll learn about each other more after those sad moments and how many opportunities we miss to spend more time together. As I said at the beginning, there are so many questions, valid questions, which each and every one of us ask today. Dear Mom Mavis, it is hard to lose a son. Dad Stanley, it is hard to lose your son. Simba, it is hard to lose brother. Wadzi, it's so hard. Tammy, your heart is broken now. It's so painful to lose your fiancé. And who wasn't touched as we were watching those photos, hearing those amazing stories? We don't want to be here. We don't want to be here today. And yet at the same time, the sad occasion we all gathered here unites us all. We are all, whether we like it or not, or whether we accept it or not, we are all brothers and sisters in this. Those moments are moments of tears, of grief, of death. And many questions are raised. Question is, why do we need to die? And yet that is too far, but why did Shingi need to die? He was so young and just started his life and career. Why? Why do we live, actually? Why do we need to live? My friends, have you ever asked those questions before? Why is there always something which intercepts those beautiful moments of life, in life, when we love life and we want to live this much? Why? And you have right to ask those questions, because those are valid questions. What is the answer? Is there an answer? Is it true what Seneca once said, that the whole life is nothing else but the path to death, he said? Ask those people in Ukraine today. Ask people in the Middle East. Ask those countries I came from. In other words, is it true that our life is nothing but a journey from one hospital where we were born to another hospital where we finish our race? Or, as a Nobel Prize winner Ivo Andrić once said, we are already dead, he said, but are just waiting for our turn to be buried. He was a wise man. You see, my friends, against the reality of death, there is the reality of life. That is the desire to be together, to be happy, to enjoy life, to be successful, to build our career, to have family, to help others, to find purpose in this life. Deeply within us, there is this indisputable desire to live. And regardless to your object of faith, whether you believe in God as Shingi did, or maybe you don't, that doesn't really matter at this space, at this place. We are still friends, we still have the same blood, we still love each other. That is where I stand. And we all do not want to die. We are afraid of death. It is not welcome. This death is an intruder. It's not welcome here. We all agree with Anton Pavlovich Chekhov, who once said, even in 1,000 years, men will still be loudly expressing, it is hard to live. And at the same time, just as it is now, he will be afraid and will not want to die, says this wise man. That is so true. We don't want to die. And yet, that is so real. And we all express that. We all experience that. And I want to commend you, and I'm really proud of you that you came here today to support a family. I knew Shingi. I knew Shingi since Pastor Andre and I worked together several years back. And then with Pastor David continued. I knew him through Wadzi and Valentin later. He loved life. He was a joker. He was an honest man, man of integrity. He ticked all boxes on the resume. You want that man. You want beside. And there is one question, my friends. What actually qualifies us to be like Shingi, to be like Oli? Parents, you did an amazing job, good on you, by raising this young man, a man of integrity. Wadzi, Tammy, I'm really inspired with your love and care for Shingi. Since you reached out and we prayed and took this seriously, I can see that care and love for him. Big time. What a great lesson for all of us. When I visited him on Wednesday in hospital, he was in a bed. And when we touched each other, you know, that touch is a touch for the whole humanity. We're all in this situation. Sooner or later, my friends, we'll be in this situation, in this context, whether we like it or not. As someone said at the beginning, you know, maybe we're already dead, but we've just been buried according to some order. But you see, in Shingin's example, there is no order. 32 is so young. And then I can't help myself but to ask that serious question, my friend, regardless your background, regardless your where you come from, is this a purpose of life? Are we here because of that reason? To live 32 years, to have a great career, which is awesome, we all want that, to have great family, and finish our journey, life journey. You know, my friend Shingi deeply believed that that's not the purpose in life. There must be something more to it. There is something which WHO, World Health Organization, calls something like spirituality. Some people will call this different names. But in other words, there is some kind of connectedness with something which is bigger, stronger, smarter than us, which actually is a source of that faith which Shingi had. Even on a deathbed, he was as such. He was a hero. He was a fighter. Something which left us in legacy, as we said. I want to be like him. I want to have that faith. I want to continue despite the obstacles, the valley of death and tears, and you name it. I truly believe, my friends, that Shingi had a big reason for that. And that reason laid in that faith, in that object, as I call it, God, Jesus. You can call it whichever name you want. But I have big reasons to accept this faith of Shingi. You see, Shinki believed in a strategic plan. He had strategic goals. When we set certain plans and smart goals, but also long-term goals as well, we talk about strategy. His strategic goal was something beyond this world, beyond something which we can comprehend. In an old book, there are texts written about 2,000 years ago, texts of encouragement which I want to leave, family, with you. We find them in the book of Revelation, an apocalyptic book, Apocalypse, which means the end of something. And we can see and agree that this world is rather in turmoil and has some rather strange things happening right now as we speak. And this man, 2,000 years ago, claims some amazing words, which I'm going to share with you, the words which Shinji Oli believed wholeheartedly. This is what it says. "Now I saw a new heaven and new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away." Benji, where are you, Benji? You read those texts, which are so inspiring texts. And I want to add on those words which you just shared. Wise words. This man, his name was John. He said, "I saw a new heaven and new earth. I long for this new earth and new heaven." You see, my friend, science today says we want to go to Mars, and good on Elon Musk for doing these amazing things in science, and I believe in science, and I look forward to see how things unveil. But what was written 2,000 years ago, there was someone who claimed that he saw a new earth and new heaven. And listen to this: the first earth has passed away. Just recently, I read an article on current situation in our world today, my friends, and this is not pessimistic, but just realistic, rather, I'd say. And he said, "What on earth is going to happen next? Is this something? Are we going to express some new start?" You see, my friends, 2,000 years ago, in something which I call Holy Book, or the Bible, which Shinji believed, it says, "I saw that first earth has passed away. Also, there was no more sea." Quite interesting concept. Why there no sea? Well, the man who wrote those texts was a man who was in prison on an island called Patmos in Mediterranean Sea. Beautiful place today when you visit, but back then was not beautiful at all because that was his prison. They didn't have cells as we can imagine today. And they didn't have barbed wire because there was no need for barbed wire to escape that prison. And he was in prison because of his faith and his belief in God. But his prison walls was actually sea. And when he writes down, "There is no sea," he wants to say, "There is no prison anymore. There is freedom. There is no death. There was no more sea. Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned to her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying," listen to this, my friends, according to those words, this is God himself saying, not John, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with man, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God." And I want to leave those texts with you, the family. Tammy, Wadzi, Simba, Stanley, Mavis, please. Friends, colleagues. "And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away." Shinji had that faith. He knew that this is temporary because our complex machine, amazing computer called human body, so perfect, and yet we finish our race too early. But there is something beyond. There is something higher than this. All this life is actually former things, according to this text. God will wipe away every tear from your eyes. It doesn't say you will not cry, but it says that we will be touched by God. Tell me you are crying big time, which is normal. And do that. Don't try to suppress that. Let it out, family. Do that. There is someone who will wipe away those tears. Someone might say, how do we know this is true? How do we know this will happen? Well, there is a simple answer to this. And there is something which I call, there is the hope. Not an empty hope, which we might have, my friends. And nice words. But there is something which I call the hope of the empty tomb. This is the hope which Shingi had, the hope of the empty tomb. The tomb of Jesus Christ. We just finished this season, the Easter season, the Easter holidays. We for 2,000 years, we celebrate this Easter, my friends. But the whole purpose of Easter is that empty tomb, that there was someone who was crucified, who died for us, for my sin, for your sin, for Shingi's sin. And that one has resurrected on Sunday as we celebrate correctly. But someone might ask and say, how on earth, what are you talking about that someone can resurrect from death? How is that possible? Do you know what? My simple answer to you is, I don't have any idea whatsoever. I don't know. But what do I know is that that tomb where Jesus was laid is empty till this day today. That is what Shingi believed with all his heart. And not just that it is empty, but there are witnesses, my friends, who saw this Jesus resurrected. In 1 Corinthians, I won't read it because of time now, it says there is more than 500 witnesses, people who saw Jesus Christ resurrected alive. That means something to me. That means the world to me. And Jesus' resurrection is the hope and warrant and guarantee for the resurrection of Shingi and all of those who believe. I want to close with one quote, again, by a Nobel Prize winner, which I already quoted. And later on, there will be a poem I want to share with you. Just the first verse. This gentleman, in 1963, wrote a poem called The Bridges. He loved loved bridges. He loves bridges. There are too many trenches in the world today, too many trenches. But we need to build bridges because they connect. They connect. I love bridges. I love walking bridges. He wrote, everywhere there is something to overcome or to bridge. You see, my friends, how smart and wise that is. So many farewells, so many obstacles, so many canyons to cross, trenches. Therefore, he says, everywhere there is something to overcome or to bridge. Disorder, death, meaninglessness. Everything is a transition, a bridge whose ends are lost in infinity. Beside which all the bridges of this earth are only children's toys, pale symbols. And then this man concludes, and all our hope lies on the other side. What a smart man. No wonder he got Nobel's Prize. All our hope is on the other side. Shingi has successfully finished his race. It is up to me, up to you, to finish our race, to run our race and to finish it. What a great man. And maybe the words which I'm going to share with you, just the first verse, might actually illustrate a small glimpse or portion of Shingi's life. The title of this poem is An Immortal Poem. If you hear, I died, and I was dear to your heart, maybe something inside you will also suddenly turn gray. Have you ever thought about the true meaning of life? Like snow on your palm, childhood melting away in you. Worries. Are there any worries? Sorrows? Are there any sorrows? On the ladder of imagination, boldly climb up to your youth. That beautiful but enticing rainbow is waiting for you over there. And live your life. Live it to the very last drop. Don't nibble days like a mouse. Chew the air with all your teeth. Run faster than all the winds and the birds. Overtake them all. Because every eternity is short. Smiling faces in some mirrors all of a sudden become wrinkled. Unexpected, at some corner, a tear ambushes you. Troubles come tiptoeing. Years turn grayer. All of a sudden, the world, while you are walking, becomes more and more narrow, and your laughter quieter and quieter, and somehow distorted. Therefore, live but fully. My friends and family, Shingi described his life through his works and acts, through his life, that he lived his life fully through Jesus Christ, who was his object. And may all these be encouragement for all of us. Amen. And thank you. I will invite Helena and the team to join us, singers. We will conclude this service with song soon. You can find the words in the program which you received at the entrance. And please remain standing for the benediction. Thank you.
May I invite you to stand and sing this song of hope. Thank you.
Soon and very soon, my King is coming, robed in righteousness and crowned with love. When I see him, I shall be made like him soon and very soon. Soon and very soon, I'll be going to the place he has prepared for me. My shame forgotten soon and very soon. I will be with the one I love, with unveiled face I'll see him. There my soul will be satisfied soon and I'll let
bow our heads in a word of prayer, please. Dear God, here we are at the end of this memorial service, but just starting a new chapter in the life of family. And Lord, that is not an easy chapter. Lord, as we just sang, we truly believe the same belief and faith Shingi had, that you will come soon. And there is something beyond, something more important, Lord, or the most important. So help us that this hope, the hope of the empty tomb of Jesus Christ, fills hearts of the family and all of us. We ask you these things in your precious name. Amen. Thank you very much. You may be seated. Just on behalf of the family, I want to thank each and every one of you who were able to make it tonight for this event. It means a lot to family, and that support is much appreciated. I want to extend also this invitation and to remind you once again that there is a light refreshment in the hall on my right, on your left, just across the car parking. There is nice food there, so please, please come and let us spend some more time with the family so we can encourage them and just get to know better each other, isn't it? To use wisely those time. Thank you once again, and we will allow our family to leave this place first, and we can follow. Thank you. Take your time. Take your time. Tell me.